here is outline of my talk. And so, yeah, this is the block diagram of the K-computer. So K-computer has the about 82,000 CPUs and the 1.27 petabytes total memory capacity. And each node are connected by the six-dimensional mesh torus network. And K-computer has the two types of storage, one is the local file system and the other one global file system. And the local file system used the scratch pad for the file staging, and the which connected to the between the compute node via ion nodes. And the global file system has the user permanent files. So local file system has a broad bandwidth, but the capacity is not so large. On the other hand, a global file system has the large capacity, but not so broad bandwidth. Okay. So this is the brief profile, user and job profile of the K computer. So we have the about 150 registered projects and the more than 1,000 registered users for every fiscal year. And we also have more than 1,000 jobs per day and the more than 100 users, active users per day. Okay, and the these pie charts show the breakdown of the computing time and by job scale in the science field. So we have five major fields of science: material science, manufacturing, life science, physics, and environment. Okay, I will show you the usage rate of the K computer. So average usage rate keeps about 75% without 2012. So this is just beginning of operation. So yeah. And the so here, yeah, some projects spent their node hours completely. So computing resource was short. And here also startup of usage was slower. And I'll mention about this later. Okay, this graph showed the job count of the waiting job. So brown meaning is the number of the running job, and the orange one is the jobs ready to run. And the green means the waiting. So you can see so job congestion at the end of half always happens. Okay, you see. And the job congestion congestion at the 2013 here is was caused by too much overbooking of the computing time. So we changed the resource allocation rate from the 100% to 85% at 2014, and the it will be the 88% for 2015. Okay, so overbooking rate could be improved by about so more than 30% in 2013. Will be improved to less than 20%. So, yeah, and the here, so beginning of the 2015, start-up of usage was slower than the other half. And it caused here, and it caused the severe congestion at the end of. So we need some new policies to encourage quick start are introduced. Okay, let me move to the next topic, failure analysis. So, yeah, K-Qubit consists of extremely many many parts and the components, and the K-Qubit always works with high load, and the is used by various type of job and users. So, failure events are expected to occur more frequently than the other systems. So, failure statistics of K-Qubit includes significant information and is expected to be useful for a general failure analysis of supercomputer. So first, I introduced the number of major parts. So K-Qubit consists of the 864 computer racks, and each rack has the 24 system boards. So total number of system boards is here. So each board has the 4 CPU and 4 ICC and 32 2 gigabyte DIMM modules. So total number is here. Okay, and each rack also has the power supply units. So, and CPU and ICC are water cooled, and actually inlet water temperature was, of inlet water is 15 degrees in Celsius, and outlet is about 70. And the other parts are cooled are air cooled. So, for example, DIMM is also air cooled. So, when the failure of CPU, ICC, or system board occurred, then the system board will be replaced, which means the operation units in the system board. Okay? So, but for DIMM failure, for the only DIMM will be replaced. Okay? So, I will show you the failure rate of major parts. So, this is monthly failure rate of the CPU. Monthly failure rate is defined by this one. So, failure counts in the month divided by the number of installed CPUs. So you can see there are some spikes here, and you see the points are corresponds to the high load events. So actually here it corresponds to the full node impact measurement. So, yeah, K-Qubit achieved over 10 petaflops impact score at this point. And so you see these points correspond to the gold medal challenges. So, failure trends of CPU is almost stable, except after high load events. And this is the for DIMM. And so trends of DIMM is slightly different. So you see the trend changed from this point. So yeah, as I said, so DIMM is air-cooled, not water-cooled. So it may depends on the air-cooled operation. So here we modified the operation of the air conditioners. So there were two modifications. One is the optimized the number of working air conditioners. So from the 40 to 22. And the we also decreased the temperature of the air conditioner from 21 to the 80. So you can see failure rate after this modification is clearly improved than the before by about 40%. Yeah. So last one is the system board. So as I said, failure of system boards include the failure of CPU, ICC, DIMM, and the system body cell. So, yeah, and the, I also said, as I said, this corresponds to the frequency of the maintenance operation. So, as you can see, a failure rate of the system board seems to be reached to the plateau. Okay, and the, so average failure counts, which correspond to the frequency of maintenance operation, was about 14 times per month. In other words, so every 2 days, in average, so maintenance operation has been done. Okay, so let me compare the failure rate with the other supercomputer. And here, I found the Blue Waters result from the this paper. So you see, for CPUs, the K computer, CPU failure rate of the K computer are about quarter compared to Blue Waters one. And the so DIM module and capacity of the DIM module two systems are different. So we have to normalize by capacity. So you see, the K computer DIM failure rate is about the half of the Blue Waters. Okay, and the so I will show the system availability of the K computer. So this pie chart shows the system availability. And so you see your K computer achieved 93.6% for the system availability. And the 97.6% for the scheduled availability. So yeah, according to the annual report of the Blue Waters, 91% for the Blue Waters at 2015. And more than 60% of system failure time was due to file system failure here. So here is the breakdown of the file system failure. So you see system software bug and the invalid setting contributes more than 30%. And the next one is the irregular use. And the, so, yeah, next is the partial RAID system failure. We call the bad block, and so on. Yeah, and so let me consider about the local file system failure. Yeah, so this configuration is designed from the user requirement. So, yeah, local file system consists of many OSS and OST to realize higher bandwidth. Okay, so, and the LFS is also configured as one huge volume to provide a large share area. So these are from the user requirements. And so, yeah, larger number of OSS and OST revealed the many potential bugs in system software. And many severe failures were caused by such bug. So there are no other users which has the this kind of huge configuration. So nobody knows. Nobody faced the solution for the problem. So it was so difficult to solve for us. Yeah. And the LFS down means all service stop because it is a single failure point. So as I said, so local file system is the scratch part of the staging. So yeah, this is the really single failure points. So we learned lessons from the experience. So do not configure a file system with a larger number of OSs and OSD to avoid any potential bugs. And do not make one huge volume to avoid a single point failure. Yeah, let me show you the MTBF and MTTR of the K computer. So you know, as you know, the MTBF is the mean time between system-wide failures. So which is defined by this equation. So yeah, roughly speaking, the operation time, so available time, divided by a system-wide area stop counts. So you see, 18.6 days for K computer. So yeah, according to the Blue Water annual report, so 11.2 days for Blue Waters at the 2015. So I also, yeah, so needless to say, so longer MTBF is better, okay? So on the other hand, so MTTR, so which means the mean time to recovery, so shorter MTTR is better. Okay, so which is defined by system-wide irregular stop time, average of the system-wide irregular stop time. So 10.6 hours for K computer. And the maximum TTR was the 49.3 hours. But it's just beginning of the operation. So now the system is stable. So, and the, I couldn't find the MTTR for the other supercomputer, so I couldn't compare the other one. Okay, so next topic is the facility and the energy efficiency. So we have two sources of energy. One is the power from the power supplier, and the other one is the gas, and the we generate the electricity by gas turbine, two gas turbine power generator. And the, in ordinary mode, we operate the one generator is active and the other one is standby. So active and standby will be exchanged every 2 weeks. Okay, and the generator works also works at the backup power supply for the servers and storage when power outage occurs. But so K computer consumes a really huge power. So power generator cannot cover K computer. So we gave up to save K computer when power outage occurs. Yeah, and this slide shows the cooling, and this is the cross-section view of the computer building. So you can see there are the loops of air and the loops of water. So water loop consists of two parts. One is the loop between the computer racks and the heat exchanger. And the other one is the between heat exchanger and the chillers. And energy consumed by the K computer finally it goes to the air from the cooling towers. Yeah, so this is short, brief introduction of the gas cogeneration system. So we have, as I said, we have two gas turbine power generator. So this generator can generate the electricity, but only 30% of the potential energy of gas can be converted to the electricity. However, so 45% of the energy can be used for cooling and heating by this system. So remaining energy goes to unusable, wasted heat. So this system enables to achieve higher energy efficiency by reusing waste heat for cooling and heating. And so this is the power supply of this site. So a blue one is from the power supplier, and red one is the generated power. So you see average total power supply is 14.83 megawatts. And generated power contributes about 17 to 35% of total power supply. And this is the power generation efficiency of the generator. So horizontal line is the average generated power, and perpendicular is the power generation efficiency. Power generation efficiency is the generated power divided by a potential energy of gas. So you see, so as generated power increase, power generation efficiency also increase. So this is just a logarithmic fit. And so power generation efficiency fluctuate between 20 to 30% here. So it depends on the outputs of the generator. So 23.9% in average. So this is the power consumption of this site. So green is the consumed by the K computer. And purple is the chillers. And the blue is the air handler. So you see, yeah, and the this line is the PUE. So, yeah, according to these documents, the PUE for including natural gas power generation case is defined by this equation. So this 0.35 is important. So, which means in typical case, the natural gas power generation, generation power efficiency will be 33% in typical case. But as I showed, so we achieved only 23%. Okay, so due to the power generation loss, so there are so big loss, and the PUE tends to be higher, which means worse. Yeah, so how can we improve the energy efficiency? And there are two options. One is the just drive power generator at peak. As I said, it was not cost effective because the gas rate in Japan was so higher for past few years. But recently, the gas rate is drastically reduced, decreased. So now it's will be cost effective. So next one is the improve the cooling efficiency. So we have already done and the optimized air handler, as I said. And the next one is the modification of the cooling tower. So we just done. So yeah, and ventilation of the cooling tower was not effective due to bad design. So I'm sorry, so this picture is small. So here is the cooling towers. And so the walls are surrounded the cooling tower. And so ventilation is not so good. And we now removed many panels of the wall. And we expect to improve the ventilation of the cooling tower. And we partially we have checked the improvements of the efficiency. Yeah, let me summarize my talk. And the so the K-computer achieved higher availability and reliability and low failure rates. And more than 60% of system failure time was due to the file system failure. Yeah, and for energy efficiency, we have already done some improvements about air conditioner, air handlers, and reduced 40% of power for air handlers. And to drive a generator at almost peak, power generation loss will be reduced and the PUE will be improved. Yeah, that's all. Thank you very much.